Say good evening and greet each one in the name of Christ this evening as we've congregated together to worship. I trust that's why we're here, to worship together in the song service. Shall we bow our heads to pray? Father, we thank you for allowing us to come together this evening to worship you and to honor you, for you are worthy of all praise and honor. We pray that you would direct our service tonight, that it would draw our hearts toward you, and it would you would be pleased with our assembly, and it would be sweet to your hearing the praise and the adoration that we have to share this evening. So we want to honor you tonight. We pray that you would direct and lead in every aspect of the service. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, at this point we'll have two numbers of song to open the service.
Good evening. Let's begin with number 27 in the Hymns of the Church. Number 27.
Thank you.
I don't know what you thought when you seen the title of the program for tonight, A Night of Music. And I'm not sure either what I thought for a while. But the thought is to him sing. Music is a medium that God has created that is very sensual, very valuable. It's very needful. And it's one that we all can participate in as we worship. In Psalm 98, you don't need to turn to these. I got a number of verses we want to relate to in the devotional. Psalm 98, verse 1, it says, "Oh, sing unto the Lord a new song." I'm not sure if we're going to sing any new songs tonight. They may be new to some people. But I believe that God wants us to be joyful. Why? For he hath done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm hath gotten him the victory. Singing is a medium in which we can express what has happened to us or has happened to someone, and we can identify with it. In Psalm 95 in verse 1, it says, "O come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation." I trust tonight as we congregate together that our thoughts and our intent is to honor the rock of our salvation, which is the Lord Jesus Christ. In verse 6 of that psalm, it says, "O come, let us worship and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker." So there's action as we worship him in singing. Psalm 96 in verse 1, it says, "O sing unto the Lord a new song. Sing unto the Lord all the earth. Sing unto the Lord, bless his name. Shew forth his salvation from day to day." It's an ongoing process. And I believe as Christians that needs to be the motivation, that we are promoting the honor of our King, the Lord Jesus. Now that's Old Testament. In the New Testament, we don't have a lot of scripture relating to singing. In Ephesians 5 and verse 19, Paul writes this to the Ephesian church and to us. He says, "Speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord." Singing is an emotion. It's an emotion of our inner being. And that emotion identifies with the Spirit of God. You know, after Jesus had taught his disciples there in Matthew in regards to the Lord's Supper, it says that they sang a hymn and then they left. I think singing has a way of ministering to hearts in ways that other methods cannot touch. In Exodus chapter 15, verses 1 and 2, it's following the experience of the children of Israel when they were being pursued by the Egyptians, and the Red Sea was before them, and they were between a rock and a puddle of water. And God showed them a miraculous event And he parted the waters, and they went through on dry land. What did they do when they got on the other side? It says in chapter 15 of Exodus in verse 1, then Moses sang. I would have loved to have heard Moses sing. But it wasn't only him. It was the children of Israel, this song unto the Lord, and spake, saying, I will sing unto the Lord, for he hath triumphed gloriously. The horse and the rider, referring to the Egyptians, were thrown into the sea. The Lord is my strength and song, and he has become my salvation. He is my God, and I will prepare him an habitation, my God's, my father's God, and I will exalt him. That song was a song of victory and a song of deliverance. Nearly all music, regardless its style, whether it's rock, country, classical, or bluegrass, or gospel, comes from an experience. Not entirely, but it usually comes from a personal experience or one that they could identify with. And in those songs, oftentimes music reveals the experience of the songwriter. Gospel music is born out of an experience or a longing of the inner man as well. Let's look at worship. What is worship? That's part of our title for the tonight's program, Worship Through Music, or A Night of Music. Worship is the feeling or expression of adoration for a deity. Now, when we worship something, we are holding it in high regard. And I trust tonight that as we sing and as we listen to singing, that we worship. If we don't, then we missed it. We may have stayed as well as stayed at home, because we came to worship. The interesting thing about singing or music is that it's a media that all parties can participate in, from the youngest to the oldest, and everybody in between. And so it's a medium in which collectively we honor and we worship the King. And we give expression to our worship through someone else's experience that we can identify. Or if we have written the song, then it becomes our experience. So what does music and worship do? Music has a way of piercing into the deep parts of our soul. I think probably we all understand the reality that we have been convicted. I have been convicted personally through music, where preaching and reading was unable to touch. Music is a medium that will get into the crevices of people's hearts, that will melt them and convict them and draw them to the Creator. Music and singing helps unite us in our walk with the Lord. It's a unifier. It unifies the body of believers collectively. Hymn sings are always enjoyable. Why? Because we all participate, and it's a united effort to worship, whether you think about it or not, but that's the reality of it. We do that subconsciously. So what is the purpose of singing? Music or singing teaches us the gospel. Did you ever think about that we teach the gospel to our children through music at a very early age? Before they can read and write and understand, you sing to them, "Jesus loves me." Or building up the temple. Or "My God is so big." What are you doing? You're teaching your children the principles of Scripture. And it's done through music. Trust and obey. That's a very common song. And oftentimes, children would select that song. But by doing so, we teach them the simplicity of trust and the importance of obedience through the message of song. Secondly, music connects with God in unique ways. Music goes beyond instruction. You know, we can sit in preaching service and we can be instructed and we can be enlightened in truth, and that's all well and good. But like I said earlier, music has a way of getting into the crevices of our inner being that preaching can't reach for whatever reason. I haven't figured that one out yet. But it allows for direct connection with God in ways that a sermon cannot and doesn't reach us. Singing allows a part of our hearts to connect with God that the spoken word will not. Singing is a way of awakening, has a way of awakening a spirit of reverence that only singing can do. I believe that singing in congregational life has a lot to do with the perceptions that we gain in that worship service. You song leaders are very instrumental in setting the tone for worship. And it, like I said earlier, it's a way of uniting a group in oneness of mission. Singing is much more than a mental exercise. God has created us to communicate with the very depths of our spirit, and singing is a way that we can accomplish that. Lastly, music allows us to express our love to God with our whole being. The scripture would teach us that we're to love the Lord with all our heart, with all our soul, and with all our might. What more is there? And singing allows us to do that. Singing is one way in which we can express our love and our adoration for God with every part of our being. Worshiping through music changes and transforms us. It draws our hearts toward God in ways like no other form of worship can, nor will do, or can do. Worship through music convicts us, builds us up, and restores us. So tonight, when we sing and we listen to singing, let's worship and honor the King. Music that honors God will cause our hearts to sing. When we sing, worship begins. So I trust that's our experience tonight. All right, children's meeting. Steve Hurst is your teacher, so all the children come up and fill this bench up and sit on the floor. The overflow goes on the floor. And we'll see what Steve has for you tonight, okay? There you go, just sit on the floor, that's fine.
Thanks a lot for those. I think we all have our, you know, little things that we don't like. I'd like to read a story tonight about a little boy. His name was Jerry, and he had a little trouble with grumbling about stuff, and we'd like to see how it worked out for him. So the title of the story is The Grumbler. Jerry, I need to go to the grocery store and then to the post office, Grandma called. The post office closes at 4 o'clock, so we'll need to hurry. Aw, Grandma, Jerry wailed. We had to go somewhere yesterday. Now we have to go again today? I don't want to. I want to stay and play. It's too hot. Grandma agreed that it was hot, but since she had a surprise for Jerry, she just hustled Jerry into the car. Surprises are no fun if we tell what they are they? But after they got into the car, Jerry continued to grumble. First about one thing and then another. They had to wait in line at the store and again at the post office. And that took longer than Jerry liked. So he just kept mumbling to himself. All this time, however, Grandma said nothing. She just looked at him with an unhappy look on her face. Finally, when they left the post office, Grandma spoke. Jerry, do you know what that is across the street? Oh yes, Jerry knew. That was the park. Sudden excitement. But sparkle in his eyes. There were swings and a merry-go-round there, and always lots of children to play with. Jerry just loved the park, and he did not grumble now. He wanted to hurry as fast as he could and take a leap into the sand pile or go down the slide. Now his eyes danced with expectancy. Only Grandma's eyes looked neither happy nor sparkling. I had planned to take you to the park as a surprise, Jerry, Grandma said, but after listening to you complain for the past 30 minutes, I only want to go home now. Oh, Grandma, I'm sorry, Jerry wailed. I really am. And he began to cry. Great tears washed down his face and spattered in the dust at his feet. Only his tears didn't do him any good. Grandma was already helping him into the car for the return trip home. If only he would have known what Grandma had planned, he would not have been such a grumbler. All the way home, he was a very quiet little boy indeed. It was a custom at Jerry's house to have bedtime stories each night before he went to bed. First, they would be just a story, as Grandma called the stories in Jerry's animal book, and then they always finished with Bible stories, just before Jerry was tucked into bed for the night. This night, Grandma read a verse to Jerry from Philippians 2:14, which said, "Do all things without murmuring and disputings." Grandma told Jerry that murmurings meant complaining, just as he had been guilty of doing that very afternoon, and that disputing simply meant arguments and quarreling. Jesus is sad when we murmur and complain and argue, Jerry, Grandma told him. But not only does it make Jesus sad, it makes adults sad as well to have children they love complain and argue against them. And I think perhaps it made you sad too, didn't it? Jerry had to admit that it had. It would have been such fun to have run and played in the park with the others, and he had missed that fun. Tears threatened to run down his face, again as he remembered and Grandma put a comforting arm around him. As they knelt to pray, Jerry resolved to quit his grumbling. "Dear Jesus," he prayed, "please help me be a good boy and not to grumble and complain when I'm told to do something I don't want to do." If Grandma planned to surprise him again sometime, Jerry planned to be ready. All right, so this little story tells us that it didn't get him anywhere. And I don't think it's not just you as children who have a tendency to complain, even us as adults. Sometimes maybe we don't like certain foods or we don't like the weather, but we have to remember that we have it so good. And I don't think many of you probably have any trouble grumbling. I just came across a story and thought it would be a good one to share with y'all. So thanks for your participation, and you can go back to your parents.
I think that was a lesson for us adults. I think we'd have less children complaining if us adults wouldn't complain quite so much. I think that's a learned behavior to some degree, but that's besides the point. Thank you, Steve, for sharing. All right, the rest of the evening is the night of music. I'm going to give you the order of the service, and then I'm going to sit down, and everything's supposed to fall into place, okay? We'll have one congregational song. And then Wanda's group, we have four groups that are going to participate in singing tonight. And Wanda's group will be first, and there'll be a congregational song. And then Floyd's group will be second, it'll be a congregational song. And then Joanne's group will be third, and a congregational song. And then Trent Steiner will have the last group, and then there'll be a closing song. Whatever time it is, it'll be. So let's worship. And let's enjoy worshiping together.
.446 in the hymns of the church.
.446.
Yeah. Thank you.
743 in the hymns of the church.
Walking in sunlight all my journey, oh.
Number 838 in the Christian Hymnary, and everyone can stand. 838.
Yeah.
844 in the Christian Hymnary. And we've got to stand for this one. So go ahead and stand again. 844.
Stand up, stand up for Jesus, ye soldiers of the cross. Lift high his royal banner, it must not suffer loss. From victory unto victory, his army shall be.
Seated at your table, Jesus. Road to God, the old road.
to the hand of my Savior and friend. He shields me from evil till dangers all end. He'll take me to heaven where voices now blend. I hold to the hand of my Lord.
Hymns of the Church, song number 1013. And why don't we go ahead and stand again? The singing just sounds a whole lot better. 1013.
Oh, music that measures.
psalmist said, let us sing a new song. And there was some new songs. And there was some old songs that I haven't heard for a long time. And one of them was, the old road is the only road. That's a song that goes way back. And it's a song that speaks volumes. Well, that was a night of music. I enjoyed it. It was inspirational. Did you find yourself identifying with the messages of song? Numerous ones. And I'm sure that we could talk about that and we could have the same song. There would be different things that would stand out to different people. But that's the beauty of music. It speaks to crevices in our lives that the spoken word can't reach. And I trust that it's been an inspiration to be here tonight, that we'll go forth from here inspired and with a zeal to press forward and onward with the King. Are there any announcements? All right, thank you for coming. Thank you for those that were responsible to put a group together. I thought maybe we might have about three songs that each group had picked were the same ones, but there wasn't any. It's amazing. And I really appreciate that. And God bless you for participating. And I trust that it was an inspiration to each of us as we launch into a new week and we focus on the Creator. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you for allowing us to be together to worship. We thank you for the privilege of blending our voices together in adoration and praise, because you are worthy of all praise and all honor. We pray that you would just bless us as we continue to fellowship together and as we separate and go our separate ways, and where our duties and responsibilities call us this week, that we would be a witness and we'd be a testimony, and that we would manifest the grace of God in our lives day to day with those whom we come in contact with. And so, Father, we just pray that you would guide us and keep us in your care. Ever keep us watching for your soon return, for we know that that event is about to happen. And so we just want to be ready, watching and waiting for that great event. In the name of Christ we pray. Amen. You're dismissed.